Perth, man. Shit hot.
Why do you say that?
Ah, it's just so far away and it's hot. I don't know, maybe a recency bias because I also got smoked at the tennis, but there's nothing happening there, you know? It's just, I don't know why you'd want to live there. 40 degrees. This is much nicer. I mean, a little bit wet today, but I like this weather in New Zealand, you know? Just cooler. You can wrap up. I mean, if you're living in Perth, fashion-wise, when could you ever wear like a nice jumper like this, a nice sweater? You're always wearing shirts and they're always drenched in sweat. I sort of love the winter for that, you know? You can, I mean, this is probably not ideal for tennis training, but fashion-wise, just throw anything together you want. Well, this is Swaopa. It's the first tennis courts I've ever played on just there, local tennis club. Here's the school on the right, Swaopa School. Be kind, be safe. Great school. Best school in New Zealand, we used to have a saying. Yeah. Good school.
Aussies.
Well, I'm 23. I think I first got a racket around the age of 2 when I could walk. We used to have one of those paddle tennis things in the yard that spun around. Just got hooked on it and I was really good. So I just, you know, played a lot, every sport growing up, but then suddenly tennis was the one I always wanted to be a superstar at. So I had to choose tennis.
I mean, the professional tennis in New Zealand is tough. Mm. Really tough. I mean, it's hard to make it. Not many have made it.
I'm probably actually a better temper and bowling player than I am a tennis player if I had to pick one. But I mean, career-wise, there's more money in tennis. I just like it more. A lot of doubters, people who say you can't do it. But in reality, I was actually listening to a podcast by Tony Robbins earlier today. And he said, you know, the only voice that matters is your own voice. And yeah, my voice is telling me pro tennis is where it's at for me.
Oh, little Leighton. He was the cutest thing. He was really good at sport. He played in all the teams at school. And he was really good. He always got good parts in the school play as well. You know, I thought he had huge potential there. I would have loved to see him be a movie star, but he really did settle on the tennis in the end.
Yeah, and he was really good at quite a few different sports. Played at county level in hockey, tennis, golf, probably a few others, but just a pure natural, eh? Pure natural. Oh, the 10-pin bowling, that's, nearly forgot about that. 10-pin bowling, he really shone. Yeah.
Amazing, just not amazing sure at the 10-pin bowling.
Not sure how he got that off, but anyway, we'll see. Yeah, so he was about the best bowler in the North Island, really. But after a while he went off that and he's put his time and effort into tennis and he's doing really well. I think he's got a great future with the tennis. Just needs a lot of practice and really give it his all.
Yeah, and I think there's money. My God, think about them in the Wimbledon and the where else do they play in the world? All over, don't they? And he, you know, he really wants to get to the States because I know he wants to meet Cliff Richard and who's Randy Newman?
I've got a lot of heroes, and they're not necessarily athletes. Tiger Woods, for example, just outstanding. Michael Jordan, Michael Jackson. Randy Jackson too. I mean, he's not even an athlete, but I really like the musical side and that drive. And I think I was a big, speaking of idols, American Idol is probably my favorite TV show I watch.
Really?
I've watched those seasons, I'd hate to know how many times, but I think Randy Jackson is one who you know, I really, I'm really drives me. I want to get to that US Open, play in New York and meet Randy. That'd probably be it for me. Nutrition's definitely something I don't take lightly, and a lot of the stuff I got here is homegrown. I've got parsley from the garden, blueberries from down the road, kale, feijoas from the tree. They're in season at the moment, so green smoothie to start the day, can't beat it. Right, a shave, breakfast. It's important after a tournament, reset, and then go again. So, time to get some training in. Said he like fur, took the mahi to work. I kicked it to the curb, took the honey and swerve. G, I got all of the burn, money to earn. Swam pushing in the hood, G, I'm pulling the burbs. Like, pull up and pull up the skirt. Shorty shot an Uber just to fill it with dirt. And still I walk back for the filling on. Kill it from the back, bite the pillow, baby. Pillow talk, pussy nine lives. I'm about to kill them all and I'm fine dying. I've been adopting a solo training method. Just to be a bit more zen. I think as a tennis player, you can't rely on anyone else. I see a lot of people relying on coaches, training partners. What happens if they can't make it? What happens if they let you down? Leighton. I gotta be all about Leighton. I can't be about my coaches or my trainers or whatever. Strengths will probably be my composure. Got real level-headed parents, and no matter how many times I get beaten up, you know, I always come back, come strong, come often. Weakness. Well, that podcast was talking about how I shouldn't talk about weaknesses, but if I had to say, probably my serve, especially my second serve. Actually, strength would be my slice, no doubt about it. I mean, some people call me the pizza boy because I got such a strong slice. Some people also call me the McFlurry because I got a soft serve. That's my thunderbolt. This one's the McFlurry. Sort of catches people off guard though. Did you see how far along it was?
No.
Well, first of all, Mum's actually a physio by trade, so injury is something I've not really had to deal with.
Because you see, what it is, okay, and let go. What we're doing here is stretching his hip flexors, but sometimes people come and their knees way out here, and that's because they're tight in the quad as well. Okay, for the lockout.
It's probably hardship.
Mm. Yeah, now I'll get the knife.
Yo, come on up. This is it's my Zen den up here. When I'm home, I've done training, I've done my recovery stretching, got to get some time away from the family, you know, they can be a little bit chatty. I like to come up here and chill. Like, people have sort of things they like to do. Some people like gambling, some people like partying. I myself love watching TV, in particular these tapes. Now I got a little treat, American Idol season 5. I've got all the tapes 3 through 8, but season 5, hands down my favorite season of American Idol, so we're just gonna get the Sony fired up.
American Idol auditions are underway in Chicago.
Let's get back in the audition room.
Hoping to make his way unscathed through the audition room was 21-year-old Kevin
Brown. I can't believe he's 21. Kevin, what's going down? Looks like the guy from Blue's Clues.
I'm going to sing The Weight by the band.
Actually by Aretha Franklin, The Weight.
I picked up my bags, I was looking for a place to hide. When I saw Carmen and the devil walking side by side.
And so I said, hey, Carmen, come on, girl, let's go downtown. But she said, no, I gotta go, but my friend is still around.
One thing I don't like about Simon, he kind of like controls the other two judges. I mean, Randy's just a people pleaser. He's such a nice guy that he'll agree with Simon pretty much about anything. And Paula doesn't seem to have that much, I mean, opinion. It's like Simon runs it and the other two, sometimes they're like puppets. And it breaks my heart because I know they've both got such good taste. And Simon's so nasty, but he just brings them down. I think you just have to be your own person. I wish I could... If I got to meet Randy, that's probably one of the first things I'd tell him. Ask to get a photo. I mean, I just like the idea every day. I believe in life, but you sort of got put in the work. I don't necessarily know where I'm running, but I know I do 10 kilometers every morning and I'm getting closer to something. And that's sort of money in the bank, in my opinion. You know, this is the work, it's the grind. You got to do it every day. And even when you don't want to, sometimes when you don't want to, you need to do it twice as hard. That's the days you need to do it the most. Yeah. So I do, I do 10Ks every morning. Just do a loop around the block. I'm going to go now, but I'll be back. See
okay.
you later on.
All right. So see you.
Take it easy. Yeah, I like sacrifice a lot. Social life. I wouldn't say friendships is something I have much of. And I, you know, since high school days, I look around, I see all the people I used to go to school with having a good time on Instagram, Facebook, whatever. They got girlfriends, they're out partying, having at the beach. And I'm here sort of busting my ass. And sometimes I just wonder what for. Like, why am I doing this to myself? You know, I could be out there having a good time, but I'm here, I can doing laps of the block. I'm here practicing my serve. I'm here doing forehands, backhands, just working on my slice day in, day out. And I haven't tasted the reward from it whatsoever. Will it come? Fuck, I'd hope so. But, I mean, am I missing out on years of my life I'm not going to get back and making memories with friends? Yeah. Sometimes I feel trapped a little bit, like I'm so far down the track. I can't just go back now, you know? I've been so stubborn for so long, telling people this is what I'm doing, that I've backed myself into a corner and all I can do is try and make it. I can't face all the people who told me I can't do it, if they're right. I just can't have that. Just a little something I've been working on for the guitar for Christmas. So you wanted to do an interview about what? More tennis stuff, kind of background story. Yeah?
Yeah, maybe some stuff about your workouts and...
Yeah. Sorry. 2 seconds. US number, that's weird. Hello? Speaking. Yeah. Really? A wild card audition. Hang on, can I quickly check my calendar? Yeah. Hang on, sorry, my calendar's back in January. Wait, so 2 weeks from today. 1st of May, Friday the 1st of May. Wow, Jesus. All right, could you please email that through to me? Sweet.
Oh my God.
All right. Sweet ass. Thank you so much. All right. Talk soon.
Sweet. Bye. Mum! Mum! Do you know what that was? American Idol just rang me up. So a couple months ago, I entered this American Idol wildcard competition because they want people from overseas to audition to be on American Idol. And I was like, I entered it. I forgot I'd even entered it. And then they just rang me up and said, I'm into the final stages of auditions in 2 weeks.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, 1st of May in Auckland for American Idol. I can't believe it.
Like a screening or?
Yeah, mum freaked. Like a full-on audition for it.
Wow.
Yeah. This just gives me so much to think about, and my brain's a bit fuzzed up now, so when my brain gets a bit fuzzy, I like to go out on the farm and, you know, to the paddock and just sort of hit some golf balls and hang out with the sheep. You know, people just think I'm a tennis player, but there's so much more to me than just tennis. One thing I know I'll never be is a sheep and following people. I don't like that. It's something I aspire not to be. But hey, nothing against these sheep, they don't know any better. People get all this thing where they feel like they have to start training at this time and do their stretches at this time, eat their salad, whatever. Like, they're so rigid. I like the idea of sort of freestyling your training a bit more, and just if you see an opportunity, going for it, not having to be like, oh, that's not in my training schedule. Fuck, you get so wound up with all the paperwork and all the goals, people forget that you gotta just actually move. You know, so when I come over here to the shed, there's so much shit over here. There's always something you can move on, you know, like this ladder on the ground. I like to just come over here and great weather outside, so I think I'm just gonna probably have a rest day today and be back to it tomorrow. But
I think he gets his artistic side from me. I sometimes think maybe that the pressures, that the tennis is just too much pressure for him. Sometimes I worry. He puts on this big, bold, rough exterior, but underneath it all, I just remember the little kid who just loves to dress up as Batman. And I still see that sometimes. I think this audition is a really exciting opportunity for Leighton. He's a good person, and I believe good things come to good people.
Yeah, a man of his age really needs to start working it out himself. The world doesn't have handouts. Isn't that right, Gus? No handouts for you? No, you have to work for him, mate. Yeah, he'll figure it out eventually.
You are the biggest star we've seen in these infiltrated.
British invasion.
Yeah. I mean, the new American Idol. It's alright. Katy Perry, Lionel Richie, that other guy. I mean, there's no Randy Jackson spear. There's also no Simon Cowell's there, so it's a bit of a trade-off. But this guy's good. Panther, hey! What's up, Panther? What's going on?
Leighton, what's shaking, buddy?
Oh, nothing. Hey, just chilling out. Just got back from Perth. I'm just watching some TV. What are you up to?
Not watching that American Idol shit, are you?
Nah. I'm watching the Joker movie. Have you seen it?
Oh, fuck, are you kidding me? That's got to be one of my favorite films. I mean,
yeah.
I thought Heath Ledger blew it away, and then Joaquin Phoenix comes in and delivers that performance. I mean, it's just fucking unreal.
Yeah, he's a stud.
Anyway, I could talk about this for hours. So let's get down to the reason why I called. Obviously, Perth didn't go as planned.
Shocker.
Got knocked out first round.
It was ugly, man. Seriously ugly. Did you see it? Hey, did you catch any of it?
I did. I saw some of the footage. Yeah, to be honest with you, man, you just look fucking stiff as a Tin Man out there in the Wizard of Oz. We got to get you loosened up, open up those hip flexors. Well, what's your take?
Yeah, I mean, I felt pretty tired out there, to be honest. And, like, just tired as well.
We got to get those. You've been taking those smoothies? You've been...
Yeah, I've been having the smoothies. Yeah.
You got to get that spinach and the chia seeds in it. Chia seeds are so important down the stretch. Energy kicks. I mean, it's, you know, you got to do it. But anyways, listen, there's a reason why I called, and that's because Bob Seidel from Arizona, big wig, Indian Wells, set a spot opened up. So
wait. Indian ATP Indian Wells, the spot for me.
You got it. Listen, buddy, I am fucking grinding for you.
What?
No, listen, it wasn't an easy sell. You got knocked out in some fucking bullshit tournament first round. But listen, you got fucking talent. Everybody knows that, okay? You're a hot commodity. You know, stock goes down, something like that. But listen, nobody gives a shit about last week. They care about what you do at their tournament. So basically, that's the deal. I mean, you got nothing going on.
Not really. I don't know what to say, Panda. This is shock. Indian Wells.
Listen, this is a fucking no-brainer, okay? I basically said yes on the spot because this is your first ATP event.
Wait, hang on. Indian Wells. Fuck, isn't that... it's the first week of May, right?
What the fuck is this WIFCON? No, listen, it is. I know it's short notice.
Yeah.
But the reality is here, you know, you got a fucking fat purse. And if you run hot and you go straight through to the semis, we're talking a six-figure payout here. And, I mean, we're not talking about the fucking Brockhampton Classic here, not some fucking chump purse. I mean, this is big money.
Yeah, shit. All right, well... But I need to get accommodation. I need to get a visa. It's in America. I need to sort that out. Travel.
Listen, Panthers got you covered. Okay?
Really?
Listen, I know a guy, Al Gurwitz, at the embassy, based out of LA.
Al Gurwitz.
Anytime I need a visa, last minute, fuck, he's good as gold. He makes good on anybody in my stable.
How did you manage to pull that one out?
Dude, whatever. It's a long story. Give you the cliff notes. Basically, what happens is, he's a huge Lakers fan, by the way. I mean, he's a fucking massive Lakers fan, just like anybody based out of LA would be. So I get him courtside tickets, right beside courtside. Jack Nicholson.
Oh,
right beside Jack Nicholson. Watching him, watching that whole show. Fucking brilliant. But anyway, listen, you in or what? I gotta go.
Man, tell Bob Seidel Leighton's good to go, right?
Listen, it's done. It's done.
You already told him? Good. Indian Wells? Holy listen, shit.
Hey. I gotta go grab lunch with fucking Nick Kyrgios. I don't even know what the fuck he's
thinking. Wait, are you? Nick Kyrgios, are you in Canberra?
Yeah. What fucking shithole.
Oh my god.
So, listen, here's the deal. I mean, it makes fucking Perth look like Paris, this place. I just want to go get it over with. But anyway, speaking of Paris, if you fucking go well down there in Indian Wells, we're booking our ticket. Full itinerary to Roland Garros, okay?
Grand Slam. Holy.
Listen, kid, you're fucking good. You gotta start believing yourself. Let's fucking get this thing. Stay loose, alright?
Alright, mate. Talk to you soon.
Later.
Say hi to Nick from me.
Will do.
Hey. Holy shit. For a moment, I was feeling like I had you. Didn't wanna leave. Good to see you, dude.
the audition.
That's the exact same day as American Idol auditions.
Wait.
Fuck.
What are you gonna do?
Shit, I don't know. You know, Panther getting me into Indian Wells is huge, but we do pay him $5,000 a month. I sometimes wonder what his motives are. And I suppose with this American Idol, I feel a little bit like Samwise Gamgee, and a little bit afraid to leave the Shire, if you know what I mean. But if I take that leap, and if I do take that leap, there could be a huge adventure out there for me. You know, follow Frodo instead of just sort of hanging about with Merry and Pippin all the time and never going anywhere. So I rang up Panther last night and I said to him, Panther, you can shove an ear whales up your ass. Go to American Idol, baby. Sometimes you gotta cut a bitch loose. I beat my dad, his shoulder's buggered now, so I've taken him down. I've beat his mum many times. My brother Digby refuses to come on the tennis court. He doesn't really like sports that much. But yeah, put it this way, he beat me at a motorbike race. People talk about spreading your eggs, don't put all your eggs in one basket. But I'm trying to flip that theory. If I put all my eggs in one basket and really look after that basket, which is, in this case, is my tennis, then takes care of itself. So I think backup plan is just really a weakness. So answer question, no backup plan.